Hello, 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 hello to YouTube. This is all the magic Spellbound. You know, I was planning on not being fully equipped in iron gear. I was planning on showing you the very beginnings of the server. I had so many plans, but you know what they say. The best laid plans are crippled by bad planning. So I didn't do any test recordings, and the recordings all corrupted, and it just didn't work at all. Moose is lagging a little bit, apparently. That's okay. He's... okay, somebody's connecting to the server. Anyway, we're playing all the magic Spellbound. We've got a little bit of starter equipment going on. I've made myself a backpack. Me and... hello, I miss you. My wonderful fiance went caving yesterday on the stream. Streamed for like 3 hours. It was super fun. We're streaming right now as well. You can follow the stream and get notified when I go live at twitch.tv/MizunaGames. And you absolutely should do that. Highly recommended. We have a lot of fun over there. We chat all the time. And yeah, we're just playing some games. Here she is. The woman herself. Look at her. Yep, she's in the world, but not in the world yet. That's fine. Okay, so the plan for today, starter house, starter gear, get some stuff going. I've got iron, you know, we're using the Tetra mod. We'll go more into it later, but it's a mod that allows you to do some weapon configuration and such. Those of you who play modded in 1.16 plus know it already. But if you've never seen it, it's like Tinker's Construct, but a little bit... a little bit different. I would describe it as simpler at its surface and more complex at its depth. It's a little bit of both. Very interesting. I like the mod. We're also going to be, like I said, building a starter house. We've chosen this little glade to build in. Just gonna put down some, you know, some basic roots in this little forest glade. It's gonna be cute. We should have a great time. Anyway, I'll be back with you when I have more plans for what we are going to do today and when I get actually rolling. Be right back. Let's see. The first mod that we want to get into is... Could get into Batania. Interesting. Elemental Craft. Never played with it. Should be interesting. Nature's Aura. Never played with it. Vampirism. Very fun. I don't know why this one has a check mark or an exclamation point. Let's see. Then there's things that I'm super familiar with, obviously. We've got your Batania I'm super familiar with, Ars I'm pretty familiar with, Astral pretty familiar with, Blood Magic very familiar with. Never played with Eidolon and Malum. Never played with Evilcraft. Never played with Forbidden and Arcanus or Hexeray or Mahou Sukai. Played with Mana and Artifice a little bit, maybe. Occultism, played with it a tiny bit in Enigmatica 6. Wasn't a huge fan, but it might have gotten better, or we might play with it more. Psy, very fun. We were just talking about that. Let's see. Create, obviously a very cool mod. I think we start Batania. I think we start Batania, and here's why. Because I want... to step up 2 blocks, and I know that in a single day I can get from the basics of Batania up to the point where I can get my first runes and get my belt of the Traveler, I think is what it's called. So, we're gonna go ahead and gather up a bunch of mystical flowers, we're going to go ahead and start on Batania. And that should be a good time. So let's do it. Let's go do it. Okay. You see the fart bubbles. Oh, I've got a little bee. The heck? I didn't notice the little bee. We'll talk about that in a second, apparently. The little fart bubbles, the purple, right? I got bit. I got bit by a vampire. You can see it up here. Sanguinaire Vampirus. Yeah, we're gonna be a vampire soon. Now, what is this bee? What is going on with this bee that's floating around me? Do I have... Is there any reason for that? Is it a bobble? I have a bee now too, not sure why. Weird. It shows up in the inventory screen too. Okay, anyway, just wanted to let you know that, YouTube. We are streaming right now. Gonna keep exploring a little bit. We're still picking flowers, right? That's where we left off. It's the next day. A little peek behind the curtain for you. Be right back. It's happened. We need to... I think I'm about to die. I think I'm dead. Give up? Why is there a give up button? What? Okay, so vampirism happened. And I died. I guess because it was daytime would be my guess. I guess this is the first mod that we're getting into, everybody. I'll come back with more info. Well, that's a look. That's interesting. I wonder how they're doing that to the skin. They must be, like, detecting where the eyes are. That's pretty cool, actually. Pretty cool. So, yes, we are not dead. This is good. Well, we are dead, but we're not. We are now a vampire. We've been given some gifts by a friend. We have an altar here. We are a level 2 vampire. You can see here, skill screen, and now we have night vision, which I can toggle by pushing N. This is cool. I know how to not die. I was dying because I had these pants on, if you look at these. Poisonous to non-hunters. It says it right there. And they sure were. They killed me right quick. So that's good to know. Now that we don't have those on, we are not dying. So that's great. We've got some other stuff that we can look at later with vampirism. We're going to switch gears here. We're going to go back to Britannia for a little while. We're going to try and gather up our purple flowers and our dark gray flowers. And then I want to get some of the baubles from Britannia. Also, one more thing, sorry. We need to gather up some more leather because apparently vampires cannot effectively wear heavy armor. So look, now we're much faster without it. Okay, that's cool. That's good to know. Good to know. All right, so YouTube, I'll be back. I'm gonna gather those last two flowers and then we'll be back with the beginnings of Britannia. Apparently, no. You can turn cows into vampires. Look at his face. What a stupid little, ridiculous. Does he drop something? Vampire potato? Yeah, for sure. Wow! Oh, wait, no. I'm being stupid. My sword is broken. Okay, did he drop leather? No. Interesting. Very interesting. Okay, so, Petal Apothecary. I've already got a Pure Daisy, but I wanted to show you guys how this works. You've got a Petal Apothecary. You use a bucket, right? With a water source, dump the water in. To make a pure daisy, we need 4 white petals in there. So you go 1, 2, 3, 4. And then you throw a seed. I'm gonna guess that this seed doesn't count. Oh, it does! Yes, it's registered. Excellent. So that's how you use this thing to craft flowers. All right, I've set up my pure daisies here. I'm smelting some stone in there. You just put wood and stone around your pure daisies, and it will transmogrify it into living wood and the living stone. So if I get out here, it is raining now. And check this out. After, I think it's 90 seconds or something, this will, of course it's raining. and I've got weakness because it's raining and I'm a vampire. This is fine. Don't worry about it. After about 90 seconds, thank you, this will become any time now living wood. Now. Oh wow, it's longer than I thought it was, huh? They've also changed these particle effects. They used to be different. That's kind of cool. There it goes, living wood. Ah, yes. Beautiful. All right. And then I can just vein mine this, right? Yeah. And now I've got living wood. Excellent. And this can be used for all sorts of things. Apparently you can use it for living wood pickaxes and stairs and incense plates. Incense is actually pretty cool. Drum of the Wild. This is very handy later. We can use it to help automate a farm for flowers, mystical flowers. And then Living Rock we need for a mana pool. So let's set that up. All right. There's an eclipse right now, but it does not block the sun damage for vampires. It's unfortunate. We've got the things that we need in order to make some endo flames, which is a basic flower that can create some stuff for us. It takes 2 brown, 1 gray, 1 red, and a seed. Now, there's a way in Britannia that I believe is like this. Yeah, where if you've just done something, you can just right-click with an empty hand, and if you have the stuff in your inventory, it just autofills them. Isn't that cool? So what we'll need to do here is like this. Yeah. Go like this, here, here, right-click, here. Here, here, here. Yeah, we're making endo flames. And these burn coal and wood and other burnables and convert them into mana. They put them into a mana spreader, and if a mana spreader is aimed at a mana pool, it'll slurp it over into the mana pool, and then it'll be available for use. So I'm going to make a few more of these. We're going to generate some mana real quick, and then we're going to get on to the next portion of what we need to do here, which will be the runic altar. Yes, the runic altar, which will take some mana diamond, and basically this is how we'll make those runes we need for the Sojourner's Sash. So, I'm going to make some mana, and I'll be right back with you. Okay, mana spreader, endo flames, coal. They should just eat the coal. And now we're making mana. All of them are active, okay. And now we're making mana. So this now can be used. Oh. That's weird. You can apparently block mana streams now with your body. That's new. That's not something I'm familiar with. Anyway, now we'll use this mana to do things. For instance, make mana steel. Bam! Mana steel. And mana steel is super cool because it can be used to make tools that can take mana to repair themselves. So for instance, I can exchange my sword blade through Tetra, mind you, because those mods are, they've got compatibility with each other, which is super cool. And I can take my sword blade and make it out of mana steel. And it should be just better. Like, if I craft this, let's see. Damage goes up by 1. This item will use mana to repair itself over time. Repairing 1 point of durability costs 133 mana. Oh, I didn't actually push the button. So, yeah, that's super cool. We can do stuff like this. And that, I think, is neat. Anyway, now we're going to work towards the runic altar, get some more things going here to get towards our end goal of the Sojourner's Sash. I'll be right back. All right, I've made myself a mana tablet. out of the first of our mana diamonds. This stores mana, and you can keep it on your person, and it'll repair your tools and things like that. However, it needs mana to function, and to get mana out of this pool, we're going to need a living wood wand. Nope. Is it just living wand? Wand of the forest, which it's a flower. It's about flowers, but that's odd. That's fine. We need one of these, which is just three living wood twigs and two petals of any kind. Living wood twigs, super easy. Just a little bit of living wood. Like so. We need more living wood. I'll make some. We're going to make a wand. And then basically we'll use this. We'll right click on the altar or on the mana pool. It'll change it from being take to give, basically. So it'll supply its mana to anything that you throw into it that can store mana, like a mana tablet. All right. Be right back. Wand acquired. Mana pool is, you can even see it now that we're looking at the mana pool with the wand. Tablet to mana pool, don't want that. Want shift right click, mana pool to tablet. Throw tablet, slurps up the mana. It has a tiny, tiny amount of mana in it now. We're gonna need to generate more mana, so I'm gonna go mining. Yeah, so we've got the basic setup here. We've got the mana spreader into the runic altar, mana spreader into a dragon. Mana spreader into a mana pool into the mana spreader into the runic altar. Now we need to actually make some runes. So, rune of earth. Mana powder, that's just redstone thrown into the mana pool, easy. Mana steel, iron, mana pool, easy. Stone, easy. Block of coal, easy. Mushroom, easy. And you get two of them. So, let's go ahead and do this. We just need some redstone. We're gonna need two of these, so I'm gonna grab two. We're gonna need two mana steel, gonna grab two. We need some stone, got it. We're gonna need a couple of living rock as well, actually. So let me go ahead and, do I have some in my inventory? I certainly do. Block of coal, that's simple. We've got coal in our inventory from mining just a moment ago. Block of coal, and then I just need a mushroom, and I think I've got one. I think I've got one. Right? Please? Default? I don't think this'll work. I don't think this'll do it. I mean, it might be registered as a mushroom, but I think it might be hard-coded, so let's find out, shall we? Like other things, you just throw them onto the altar. They start to swirl around. Block of coal. Stone. Then we need mana steel, mana powder. Boop. And boop. And boop. Nope. Nope. See, it's... Alright. We're gonna need to... bother. We're gonna need to, Nope. We need a red... Oh! Found him! Found the mushrooms. Give me one. Give me a single mushroom. Please. Isn't this where you get mushrooms from? Doesn't this work? Yes. Excellent. Alright. It is dawn, is it not? A little weird. I could sleep in a coffin, obviously. If I wanted to not, Can you also right-click on this? You can. Okay. Good. Mana steel, mana powder, mushroom, block of coal, stone. Rune of earth. Crafting. Just like that. Easy. And we living rock. And we right-click. And we have rune of earth. Excellent. Halfway there. Now we need rune of air. Rune of air, feather, string, carpet, ingot, and what's it called? You know what it's called. Powder. Ingot and powder. Done. And done. String. I think we probably have some. Yep. String. Carpet, easy enough. And now we just need a feather. And hopefully we have one. I don't know why I'm looking in the wrong chest. And... oh, is it full? Am I being stupid? Yep. All right, Rune of Air accomplished. So now we just need leather and one more bit of mana steel. And I think... I thought I had leather on me. I don't. Okay, wait, hold please. Leather. Leather. 1, 2, 3, 4. And crafting table. And Sojourner's Sash. And achieved. Okay, so let's see how fast we are. First of all, without the umbrella, just as a vampire. This is sprinting, obviously. Kind of speedy. Now, put on the belt. I said put on. Hold. Wait. Does it have to go there? Yep. Oh, this is not sprinting, boys and girls. This is not sprinting. This is sprinting. Oh, we're speedy now. And we can walk up blocks. This is good. Oh, such a huge improvement. Insert outro here. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, that's gonna wrap it up for today's episode on YouTube, ladies and gents. It's been super fun. I have really enjoyed playing Minecraft again with all of you. We've still got our bee friend. We've also got these mysterious signs left for us by Perp on the server. And we're going to check those out during the next stream, which will be live today, right after you watch this video. So watch the video and then watch the stream. I was trying to get a dramatic. There we go. Watch the stream. See you soon.